Hi, my name is Cynthia Dwyer with the Office of Extramural Research at the National Institutes of Health. As stewards of federal funds, the NIH strives to exemplify and promote the highest level of scientific integrity, public accountability, and social responsibility in the conduct of science. Recipient institutions share responsibility for stewardship of federal funds and therefore must work together with the NIH to help protect the integrity of NIH-funded research. But what happens when things don't go as planned and research misconduct is suspected or confirmed? Recipient institutions have a responsibility to report to the HHS Office of Research Integrity, ORI, as outlined in the Public Health Service regulations. At the same time, recipient institutions are required to work with the NIH to protect the integrity of funded research and comply with the terms and conditions of award, as outlined in the NIH Grants Policy Statement. To help illustrate why it's important for recipient institutions to engage NIH when concerns of research misconduct occur, I'd like to share two different responses that highlight the importance of communication between the NIH and recipient institutions. These scenarios are drawn from previous experiences, but do not represent actual cases. Any resemblance to an actual case is purely coincidental.
Hi, my name is Mike Lauer, Deputy Director for Extramural Research at the National Institutes of Health. I often enjoy reading about the latest NIH-funded breakthroughs in journal articles and news stories. Occasionally, I come across a news article about NIH-funded research that is startling, to say the least. In our first scenario, the news article indicated that an institution was investigating allegations of research misconduct against a PI who subsequently resigned. At the end of the article, the reporter stated that the PI was in the process of moving to a new institution. Institutions are required to report to ORI the decision to initiate research misconduct investigations involving NIH-funded research. Since NIH was not aware of the situation, we gave ORI a call to discuss it. ORI let us know that they were aware of the institution's investigation, and they expected the report to arrive very soon. Apparently, the investigation had been going on for almost 2 years. Next, we contacted the institution for more information to get a better understanding of how the finding would impact the NIH-funded research. The institution claimed it was bound by confidentiality rules and unable to disclose information to anyone other than ORI. We then learned that the institution relinquished the award on which the investigator served as PI, and subsequently the award was transferred to the PI's new institution, which we will refer to as Institution 2. In the process of transferring the award, the institution simply stated that the PI had decided to move his laboratory to Institution 2. There was no indication that the research misconduct may have played a role in his decision to move.
Hi, my name is Patricia Valdez, and I serve as the NIH Extramural Research Integrity Officer in the Office of Extramural Research. Let's take a moment to think about the role of institutions in grant oversight. In the previous scenario, the institution's final investigation report was submitted to ORI a few months later, and the NIH requested information on the affected awards. Did the institution act as a good steward of federal funds in this case? Did it act to promote the highest level of scientific integrity? The institution may have complied with research misconduct regulations, but it failed to protect the research and the research funds. Don't forget about Institution 2. In addition to the grant, the associated problems have been transferred to them as well. Remember, these kinds of situations affect many others well beyond just one institution. NIH staff is available to work with institutions to take steps to protect the research and research funds. Consistent with ORI Confidentiality Regulation 42 CFR Part 93.108, confidential reporting can be made to NIH Research Integrity at nih.gov, and we can coordinate with affected institutes or centers if needed.
Hi, my name is Joel Snyderman from the NIH Office of Policy for Extramural Research Administration. The terms of award require that an institution acts as a steward of federal funds and maintains responsibility for performance of the project. An institution must work with the NIH to assess the ability to continue work on a project that may involve research misconduct. A change in scope of the project or a change in PI must first be approved by the NIH. An institution must also contact the NIH if it determines that an award should be suspended, pending the outcome of an investigation. Accordingly, the NIH may take actions to protect the health and safety of the public, including research participants, to promote the integrity of the NIH-supported research and research process, and to protect federal funds. If a recipient has failed to materially comply with the terms and conditions of award, NIH may take one or more enforcement actions, which may include disallowing costs, withholding of further support, or wholly or partly suspending the grant pending corrective action. NIH may also terminate the grant for cause, with or without the recipient's agreement.
Now, let's see how this scenario might have played out if handled in a different manner. This time, the Research Integrity Officer, or RIO, from the first institution called the NIH extramural RIO to inform NIH of concerns with data falsification in an NIH grant application. In addition, they informed us that potentially falsified data were included in two NIH-supported publications and that the institution was preparing to submit its investigation report to ORI. The institution's RIO followed up with a confidential email containing a list of the affected figures and indicated that the raw data could not be located for many of them. We then called ORI to make sure they were aware of the investigation, which they were. The institution had previously requested a suspension of the active award when the investigation revealed concerns with the data included in the grant application. Now that the investigation was finished, the institution contacted the NIH grants management official to request approval of a change of PI since the current PI has just resigned. Keep in mind, even if the current PI requests that the award be transferred to the new institution, the award belongs to the institution, and the institution has the option to terminate an award early or to relinquish the award to another institution as approved by NIH. If the original institution decides to keep an award, it must seek approval from the NIH for a change of PI. The institution also requested approval of a change in scope after a discussion with the NIH program official. Though the grant application contained falsified data, they were able to salvage some of the project and change direction. NIH imposed a special award condition to the grant that required the institution to implement a data management plan and to provide the NIH with the raw data for this project going forward. The institution's approach kept the lines of communication open with NIH. Therefore, when the story hit the news cycle, NIH was not caught off guard.
In the second scenario, the institution worked with the NIH early on to help mitigate the impact of research misconduct on NIH-funded projects. In general, if the recipient institution initiates a research misconduct investigation, it must take any necessary steps, in addition to its normal and ongoing responsibilities under the award, to protect the scientific integrity of the project, to protect human participants, live vertebrate animals, and the environment, to ensure the proper expenditure of funds and, if appropriate, continuation of the project during the investigation, and to provide reports to ORI. When a recipient institution finds, learns of, or suspects falsified, fabricated, or plagiarized information in materials submitted to the NIH or in published research or research products supported by NIH funds, the recipient institution must communicate this information to NIH Research Integrity at nih.gov.
So, what was the impact of handling this case appropriately? The NIH was able to make appropriate administrative changes to protect federal funds, as well as the integrity of the research. The NIH retains the authority to provide oversight regarding the management of grants and cooperative agreements.
When research misconduct is suspected, there are two paths, the right one and the wrong one. Institutions that receive NIH awards hold assurances that include promoting an environment that fosters the responsible conduct of research. Protecting the integrity of NIH-funded research and public funds is a responsibility that we at the NIH take very seriously. The research enterprise is a partnership. The NIH is committed to working with institutions to ensure that we continue to do all we can to protect the integrity of the research and associated funds. If you have any questions, please reach out to us at NIH Research Integrity at NIH.gov. We'll be here to help.